to become tired.
Pray without ceasing. You got to be connected. Now, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
How it can see
but. On earth as it is in heaven. So you can't do something on earth that's not connected in heaven.
Amen.
You can't have a church your way. You got to have it Jesus' way. Now, who is the most successful preacher? Isn't it Jesus?
Yes.
Who has grown the church greater than anyone? Isn't it Jesus?
Yes.
So, who shall we follow? Isn't it Jesus?
Yes.
So Jesus gets 12. Preacher, do you hear me?
Yes.
He gets 12. He's not running to the 5,000. He's running away from the 5,000. And he's teaching the 12. For 3 years, he talks to no one but the 12. He's discipling the 12. Are you getting me?
Amen.
Because this is the work of the authority of God. Sometimes you come and I look at the best member, the hardest worker, the one who's at every meeting, the one who's at every service, but they come by themselves. If you come by yourself, if you have no followers, you're not doing the work of Jesus. How do you think the gospel, starting in a little town that nobody even knew, spread all over the world, that Jesus didn't take it to the 5,000?
Yes,
he took it to the 12.
Amen.
So when you get the knowledge of God in the crossed out school,
yes,
now you've got to come with the burden to teach 12.
Amen.
Like Jesus taught 12.
Amen. 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 Yes.
May I give a simple illustration?
Yes.
With the front row stand. Ladies on the front row stand. Pastor.
Musumba.
If this is your first 12,
mm-hmm,
and you're teaching them in the cross style Bible training,
mm-hmm,
to rightly divide the word,
mm-hmm,
walking with them, praying,
mm-hmm,
with them,
mm-hmm,
and they become,
yes,
the disciples,
yes,
of Jesus Christ,
yes,
and you only want to teach them to do one thing, you want this one to pray all night long.
Mm-hmm.
Say, give me the name.
Mm-hmm.
Oh God, give me the name.
Amen.
Of the 12 I'm supposed to teach.
Okay.
Everything that the pastor has taught me,
yes,
I'm going to teach 12.
Amen.
Everything that the pastor has stirred up in me, I'm going to teach 12.
Amen.
Everything that I've seen in the revelation of God, I'm going to teach 12.
Yes.
Now this is a church chosen by God.
Amen.
Not by the music.
Mm.
Not by the drums.
Mm.
Not by the custom.
Yes.
Not by the money.
Yes.
But it's chosen by
God. Amen. 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 Amen.
So, this church can have a Bible training college,
yes,
to train up,
yes,
the people who will speak to the rest of the world.
Yes.
But what good is it to have knowledge and keep it all to yourself?
Wow.
I am a selfish man. On my birthday, When I was a little boy, they would bring me a big birthday cake. My name was on the cake.
Okay.
And so we got the cake. And everybody would come together. I said, no! It's my cake! This cake is for me! And I would eat it all myself, sharing it with no one. What happened? I got sick. When you get the word of God and you don't have 12 to share it, you are spiritually sick. If the church has 35 members this year,
they
have 35 members next year, it is sick. Any living thing that is not growing is sick. If you have a child, at 1 year old he's this tall, 2 years old he's this tall, 3 years old he's this tall, take that child to the doctor. Something is wrong with that child. If you're in a church, and the church has 35 1 year, 38 the next year, 40 the next year, that church is sick. But it's not something that cannot be changed. Anybody follow me?
It would be wonderful. You will be hearing
at the end of the book of Matthew.
We need a generator in this church.
For what the believers are to do. They are to go. Am I right about it? Does he say go? Baptizing in the name. Teaching all the things that you have observed. And so, if the members do not go, if the members cannot find 12 people that will follow them,
yes.
You say, well, I'm not a very good speaker. God didn't ask you to speak. So, well, I don't look very good. He didn't ask you to look good. He asked you to be filled with his spirit. And if nobody is following you, your life is not filled with his spirit. But they're supposed to look at you and see something so good that they want to follow you.
Yes.
They're supposed to see your connection with that window in heaven. They said, we don't know how she does it, but her children are always clean. We don't know how she does it, but her children are always happy. Even that no good husband, he's happy. I don't know how she did it, but she got that husband on a job, bringing home the check.
Take the picture from here, you can see him.
Amen. Amen.
When you see a woman who has a good husband, who's bringing home a big paycheck, taking care of the children, building up the house, I'm going to tell you, when a woman sees that, she's like, I want what she got. Say, what is it? What is it that you have? I have the love of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Pastor, I'm taking too long, I apologize. But I want you to get this. Pastor, I want you to get this. Because what happens, the pastor takes on the burden of trying to lead the whole church. The pastor's job is not to lead the whole church, but the 12.
Yes.
He's to teach the 12.
Yes. Yes.
Captain John.
Yes.
Is it true that the general does not speak to every man? He speaks to his officer.
Mm.
Not Now I'm going to tell you something. You don't know this. But everybody in the world has copied Jesus Christ. Did you know that? Do you know that every corporation have 12 members called a board of directors? Am I right about it?
Yes.
And they don't speak to all the employees. The president speaks to the board of directors.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
Now anybody play football? They got 12 men on the team. Anybody play baseball? They got 12 men on the team. Oh, somebody ought to hear me tonight. Everybody has taken the system of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Everybody but the church. Everybody but the church. Men, when the men pick the board of directors, man, they pray all night. They said they're going to be handling the money. They're going to be making decisions. We got to get the right men. But in the church, we say anybody. Anybody. We don't ask God. The man in the business asking God. You don't believe me. There's a man named Umseven. Do you know this man? He has a cabinet.
Yes.
He can't go get anybody to be in the cabinet. He got to consult a higher authority. Now, I will tell you this. If he is not praying to God, if he's not picking men who are holy, righteous, set aside, if he's not picking men who are Christians, if he's not giving the men who God assigned, the country will not do good.
Yeah.
I think the president needs our help. Because we got to set the example.
Yes.
Am I right about
it? Yes.
I am so glad to be with Captain John.
Captain John.
Because he's a man. When he walked up, I stood. We saw the authority and the power.
Amen.
Of
amen. Amen.
All of you recognize.
When not.
But how much more? That when you are filled with the Spirit of God and you are leading your platoon of 12, and when you stand up, Captain John's got to break down on one knee because you represent the name above every name. Hallelujah!
Amen!
Am I taking too long over my
No, you're good.
I'm going to close. I close at least 5 times. No more screaming. No more yelling. I'm going to talk to you. Now, I love to preach and shout and jump. But you know, if you read this Bible, it'll mess up your preaching. Do I want to preach like Redfern? Or do I want to preach like Jesus? Now I'm not seeing any sermon preached by Jesus where he shouted. Did y'all know that? He never shouted. Let me prove it. This is how I want you to learn. Why I want you to go to Bible. Remember when the crowd got so big that Jesus went out in the boat. You remember this?
Yes.
Have you read this?
Yes.
Now, was Jesus standing in the boat?
Yes.
Or was he seated in the boat? He was seated.
Yes.
Now, if you're seated, you're not shouting. So I start learning that as much as I like to shout, it's not preaching like Jesus. I'm also learning that Jesus didn't talk to the multitude. He wanted to talk one-on-one. That's why we say he is my personal Savior.
Amen.
A lot of people come to church and they get lost in the crowd. They don't want to be one-on-one with with Jesus. See, that's why when they go to the window in heaven, they can give their church, but they can't give their personal testimony. They say, I went to church. I sat in church. But I didn't have a personal relationship with the banker in heaven. They said, well, God said, well, what did you do to earn a right to draw down from heaven? Say, so have you saved, introduced Jesus to anybody? How many people are saved today because you introduced them to Jesus Christ? If the answer is zero, that's why you can't get anything out of the account. Now, he didn't ask you to save the world. He didn't ask you to save the world. He only asked you to get 12. He didn't ask you to know every book. He didn't ask you to know philosophy. He didn't ask you to know history. He didn't want you to know algebra. He didn't ask you to know calculus. He didn't want you to know physics. He said, if you will just study my word. One will do it. Each
one is coming. It's good. It's nice. Nice.
My brothers and sisters, we are all over Africa. Burundi, Malawi, Rwanda, Kenya, Sudan. So why have we come here? Why not New York? Why not Paris?
Yes.
Why not England?
Yes.
London.
London.
Why here? Jesus has never done anything in a big town. He was born in a little town. He grew up in a little town.
Amen.
And do you know that Jesus didn't have much to do with the bishops, the big pastors?
Hey.
In his time, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the rich people, he didn't spend time with them. He spent time with people just like
Amen.
I drove by New York. I flew through. I came past Rome. I came through Cairo. I came through Spain. I said, man, where is the Spirit of God?
Then
even the wise men do. They looked up into the heavens and saw a star. And they followed that star. And I want you to know that the star hasn't gone away. That the star, seemingly to me, has settled over East Africa. The star is over the Pearl of Africa.
Amen.
Amen.
My Bible says that those who are first. New York first. Chicago first. Los Angeles first. London first. Barcelona first. Manchester United. My Bible said the first shall be last. And last shall be first.
Amen. Ah, it's wow.
Now,
Captain,
if I were to bring a Black Hawk helicopter, park it in the lot, park it outside, and say, church, here's your helicopter. What could you do with it? You couldn't even sell it. You have not been trained. If you had the training, you could fly that thing.
Yeah.
Now, the Black Hawk helicopter is one of the most powerful in the world. There is a bomb called the atomic bomb. Nuclear weapon. If I gave you one, you can't do anything with it. You haven't been trained. Now, You have something more powerful than the helicopter.
Amen.
You have something
Amen.
More powerful than a nuclear bomb.
Mm.
You have the man who made the atom, who created the hydrogen
Amen.
That makes the bomb.
Amen.
Now you have that power, but you can do nothing with it because you haven't been trained.
Yes.
Say, Pastor,
cross-style training.
So you can find some of these things in the Bible so that you can pour into 12. So that you can walk with them, talk with them.
Yes.
Anybody with me?
Yes.
There is a church that I spoke to 2 years ago. They said, oh, we want to build a church, but we don't have any money. Please, you're from the West. You have all the money. Give me some money so we can build a church. I said, you beggars. You beggars. That's the same message Paul had to the Ephesians. You have great wealth. But you're acting like beggars. I said, organize. Get your 12 prayer group. Do you remember in the book of Numbers? So you got to know this Bible to use this Bible. Moses trying to talk to everybody. Divide him up into 12 tribes. There it is again, 12. Divide him up into 12 tribes. Assign each tribe a job. Are you seeing it?
Yes.
Are you seeing
it? Yes.
And so now, this church. I said, I am not giving beggars money. I am not giving beggars money.
Yes.
I said, but I'll tell you what I will do. I will match what you do. I said, you get your 12. You get your 12. You get your 12. And I said, every week, everyone in your 12 make one brick. You go out and make one brick. You stack it in your yard.
Amen.
That's 12 bricks in 1 week. 24 bricks. 48 bricks. 72 bricks. 1 week. 144 bricks. They put it in the churchyard. The next week, they put another 144 for a whole year. I came back. Bricks up to here. So I said, mix the mortar. Lay the foundation. And they started dancing. Every prayer group danced. All lined up. Got their bricks. So they said, let's lay the bricks. Let's build the church.
Amen.
And they picked up one brick. And they laid it on the cement. And the next one came. Laid it on the cement. And I watched the wall go up. I watched the wall go up.
Amen.
They were not beggars. They became builders.
Amen.